Hey there, it's Jerry again. And right now we're looking at the Enumerate, Contemplate, Decimate range, specifically goal form. What I want to do in this short video is explain a little bit about what SearchSploit is and how to exercise an exploitation in order to get a reverse shell on a machine just like in this range. So there will be a spoiler in here, but really the point of this video is to help you understand exactly what is going on and why it's working the way it is. So you can see I'm in here on the range. I'm already to goal 4, decimate part 1. And at this point, goal 3, you would have discovered the username and password in the range source code for the file. And you can see right here, this is those credentials for the PHPMyAdmin, okay? So we'll come back to those in a little bit. But we want to take a look at using SearchSploit. Now, if we know from previous reconnaissance on the range, we know that this web server is running PHPMyAdmin version 4.8.1. which has a really well-known remote code execution vulnerability that we can take advantage of. Now, because it's an exploit database or exploit-db.com, right here, you can see it right here. Because it's in there, it's also going to be in SearchSploit, which is effectively a command line tool built into Kali Linux that allows us to look for things. So if we look for things, we can use SearchSploit just like that. And then we can just type in phpMyAdmin 4.8.1. And you can see it comes up with 3 different vulnerabilities. And we're really interested in that remote code execution one. Now let me just take a step back because that seems like it was too easy, right? You can always say SearchSploit and hit enter, and you'll get, you know, some arguments on how to use SearchSploit, right? Like how it works. And most importantly, a couple examples. And really, I want to call your attention to this, okay? You know, we just said phpMyAdmin, we might know, like, we're looking for certain ports, certain operating systems, certain technologies, okay? So, you know, be kind of liberal. SearchSploit's a really robust tool that will allow you to kind of search for different things. But we were interested in that phpMyAdmin 4.8.1. remote code execution. So bringing up those results again, we're really interested in this. Now, here's another interesting thing about SearchSploit. You see these numbers? These are unique numbers. There's only one 50457 exploit in the SearchSploit database. So because of that, we can use the command SearchSploit -m, which stands for mirror, and just say the number 457, okay? You can see right there, SearchSploit -m 50457. And the -m says is for mirror. It's copy a local instance. You do not want to edit the exploit inside the SearchSploit database. That's a terrible practice. Just go ahead and SearchSploit M5047. And yes, we'll overwrite it. And now you can see, because I downloaded it before, you can see we have that file right there in our local directory. And if we want, we can just look at it. It's a Python file. And we could read it and we could get a little bit more understanding about what it is. But this particular exploit does not require any editing, any modification to use it. And sometimes if it does require modification, the exploit writer will tell you that. So now if we just look, it is a Python file, right? You guys can see it's a Python file. Okay, because of the .py. So if we just run Python 50457, looks like we don't have regular Python. We need Python 3 again. It's fine. You could see it gives us like, hey, you need to pass me arguments. You need to pass me an IP address, a port, a path, a username, a password. Okay. So let's do it again. And let's pass it the IP address of our target, 10.161.88.186. And yours will be different because you have a different target. Now the port is 36080, and we got that earlier because when we were doing our nmap, we knew that it was running on that port, the web server. Okay, so let's keep on going. We need the path, so it's phpMyAdmin, right? We saw where that exploitable vulnerability was. It's in the PHPMyAdmin. And the username, let's go back here, is right here because they gave us the creds. So let's go ahead and copy. And paste. And all we're doing is queuing up this exploit, okay? This is a technical exploit exploiting a known weakness with PHP 4.8.1. Okay. Whoops. I'm going to go ahead and paste that. So looking, all right, IP, port, path, username, password, those are all the things. And then some command. This is what we want to run. So let's just say ls for now. And there you go. You see, we've been able to run ls on the victim server, on that web server, and have it returned to us. So we are now able to execute remote code execution. Now, obviously, if we're going to do some remote code execution, what we want is a shell on that box, because then we can do whatever we want. Okay, so first let's figure out what our, we have to do a reverse shell. Again, we can execute code on the victim server. So if we can have it reach out to our machine to make a network connection, then we'll have a shell on that server, which is awesome, right? Executing one command at a time on the box is fine, but getting a shell is really going to allow us to do what we really want to do. So let's use netcat lvnp on the port 1337, for example. All right, so now we have a listening service. This is allowing us to now receive a reverse shell connection or network connection from the victim server. So we're just listening on 1337. Let's go back to the command. Well, instead of running ls this time, let's run a reverse shell. Now, I showed you the exploit database earlier. Now, there's a GitHub repo called Payload All the Things, which is fantastic. There's all sorts of great assets here. And you can see they have an entire collection of reverse shells. So we're interested in bash, but I encourage you to go look at all these. And here is the reverse shell that we want, okay? All right, so let's do this. Let's copy that in. And let's go ahead and I hit Control-Alt-Shift to get this pop-up. All right, I've copied it in here. So let's go back out and now let's do this. Now, obviously, there's a bunch of white spaces in between all these, so we'll have to put it in quotes. And let's see what happens. Oh, hold on. We have to actually configure this. We have to tell the victim server where to go. So we need to have it go to our server, excuse me, our Kali box on port 1337. See that? So this right here, this is the IP address of our machine. This is the listening service that we created. And now we're passing that same thing here. Okay, and we got all this from Payload All the Things here. So let's go ahead and hit enter. Now you see nothing happened, okay? So that's a problem. Now, with a little bit of research, what you will end up finding is that because you can only kind of execute one command with this exploit of the way it's set up, we'll actually have to use bash.c bash.c and then exec the bash.i. So bash.c is basically here. Let me just show you really quickly. Bash.c, as you can see right here, if the option's present, then it will read everything as a command string, okay? Which is a little bit outside the scope of this range, but just know it is now going to read this entire thing as a command string, which is what we want it to do. We want the server to execute it. It wasn't working with just the bash tack I reverse shell, so we need to bundle it up and explicitly execute it on the machine. So let's go ahead and try that and see how it works. Did you see it? We now have a shell. Dun dun! All right. So once we get that shell, this terminal server right here is now logged in to the victim machine. We are on the web server, right? Who am I? We are www-data. PWT. There we are. We're in the PHPMyAdmin directory. And when we hit ls, we get all of these things. Now, you don't have a full shell. So when you use tab complete, it doesn't return the content, but it is there. And you can see here when I did ls FLA tab, you didn't get to see the flag 4 come back, but what was actually presented to the server was that, and you can see that there is a file in here, flag 4. So by just looking at that flag, we can see, there we go. There is the flag for this particular goal. And we did it through getting a reverse shell. I hope this helps make it a little bit more context again. Learn, if you want to get deeper, learn about SearchSploit and how it works. Learn about how you can look up different exploits in SearchSploit. Look at how you use different exploits in SearchSploit. And look at the different types of reverse shells that you can instantiate using different services. And I'll just say, we couldn't use all of these, for example, because Netcat, this NC-E one right here, like Python, Perl, SoCat, some of these won't be on your victim server. You can't guess that it's going to have Perl. You can't assume that it's going to have Ruby or Golang. So you have to use this in a way that works with whatever your victim server has. I hope this was helpful. On to the next goal.